9 feet 9 inches tall, bronze armor weighing 125 pounds, with a brass helmet and a 15-pound point on his iron spear. Goliath, the terrifying champion of the Philistine army, stood across the valley from the Israelite army. Every day for 40 days, Goliath shouted, "Send me a man so we can fight." Not one Israelite stepped forward. One day, David's father, Jesse, sent David to check on his older brothers who were in the Israelite army. Jesse sent grain, bread, and cheese with David to give to his brothers and the army commanders. When David arrived, he heard Goliath shout his usual threat. He heard Goliath shout mean things about God. David asked, "Who is this Philistine who challenges the armies of the living God?" David told Saul that he would fight Goliath and that God would keep him safe. David remembered that God helped him protect his father's sheep from a bear and a lion. David knew that God would help him fight Goliath. Saul offered his armor to David, but he was not used to wearing it. Instead, David chose 5 smooth stones from the river and put them in his pouch. He grabbed his sling and walked confidently toward Goliath. Goliath cursed David, but David was not scared. David said, "You come against me with weapons. I come against you in the name of the Lord whom you have dared. Everyone will know today that the battle is the Lord's." When Goliath came forward to attack, David quickly ran to the battle line. He placed a stone into his sling and slung it quickly, hitting Goliath's forehead. The Philistine warrior fell face down on the ground. God helped David beat Goliath, and the Philistines ran away.
Hey everyone, it's me, Derek.
And me, Dab.
And me and my bro have an awesome-tastic life tip for you.
Awesome-tastic.
Bro, you ever get frustrated when things don't go the way you planned?
Oh yeah, bro. I'm still waiting on my chocolate tree to grow.
You're gonna be waiting a long time. Bro, they take like a year to grow.
Sometimes we just can't make our own plans work, no matter how hard we try.
Like the time you tried to do a self-portrait?
Bro, I threw that thing in the trash.
Bro, you know I'm not afraid of the trash.
Point is, it can get pretty frustrating when things don't go your way.
It can feel like the whole world is against you.
But we've got good news.
The whole world is against you.
Bro!
Just kidding. God actually has control over everything.
Right, so if you want to be successful at something, just convince God to get behind it. Like if I wanted to break the world record for the world's loudest burp, God could help me do it.
God may have the power to give you the belch of all belches, but I don't think that's what he wants us to use it on.
Right. He uses his power to make himself more famous, not make us more famous.
Unless making you famous makes him famous.
First off, I know that God is in control of all things, so I'd like to thank God for giving me the ability to burp so loud.
The best way to go through life is living the way you know God wants you to live.
Since he's all powerful and he wants you to share him with others, he's gonna give you the power to do that.
So that's a reminder to you.
God can control all things.
So do what he wants you to do and watch him give you the power to do it.
Bro, you ever pull any other cool stuff out of the trash?
I don't know. Is this cool?
You know it is!
Like the sun, my praise will rise. peace, my everything, my life, my soul, my heart, in every part of me. You are, you are. You are the rain washing over me, the freedom that began at Calvary, a beautiful cross on a lonely hill, a beautiful gift that he's given still. My soul, my heart, and every part of me. You are.